Okay, so how do we change fractions hours into decimal hours and then change them from decimal hours into minutes? Well, here we have a quarter of an hour. If we can't remember that a quarter is exactly the same as the decimal 0.25, it's not a problem, because the way to convert fraction to decimal is to just do the division. Okay, if I don't remember what it is, 1 divided by 4 goes 0 times, that 1 is left over. 10 divided by 4 goes 2 times, and 2 4s are 8, and we had 10, so that means there's 2 left over, and 4s into 20 goes 5 times. So this is proving mathematically that 1 quarter is exactly the same as the decimal 0.25. If we want to then change our decimal hours into minutes, we multiply by 60. It's actually easier to keep our minutes, our hours in terms of fraction, because 1 quarter times 60 is easier to work out, because we just work out 60 divided by 4, which is 1 and 2 left over, and 4s into 20 go 5 times. So quarter of an hour is the same as 15 minutes, and we know that by the time we go to year 8, I hope. 2/10, to convert 2/10 into, if we have 2/10 of an hour, and we want to convert that to decimals, well, anything divided by tens is really easy. We just move the decimal point to give us 0.2 of an hour. If we would like to convert 2/10 into minutes, keep it as the fraction form, multiply by 60. The zeros cancel here, we get 2 times 6 equals 12 minutes. So 2/10 of an hour is exactly the same as 12 minutes. What do we do then when we have decimal number of hours? Well, to convert decimals back into fractions, we look at how many tenths do we have here. We have 5/10. We don't have anything after that because there's just lots of zeros, so we look at the number that is the last number in the decimal point. So we want to know what 5/10 is in minutes. We multiply 5/10, the fraction, by 60. The zeros cancel here, 5 sixes are 30. So half an hour equals 0.5 of an hour equals 30 minutes, and we know that too. What about 0.7 as a decimal? Well, we know that, we look here, the last number in our decimal is tenths, therefore 0.7 is the same as the fraction 7/10. So if we would like to work out what 7/10 is in terms of minutes, we would take the fraction 7/10 and multiply by 60. 6 sevens are 42. So 7/10 of an hour is the same as 42 minutes. And then we've got a few more of these. We actually have 2 minutes again. These are decimal hours, and these are fraction hours. We have 45 minutes then. Well, how can we go from 45 minutes to decimal hours? Well, we do know that 45 minutes, if we think of the clock, going from 12 o'clock over to the 9, the minute hand, 45 minutes would be the same as 0.75, 3/4 of an hour. 3/4 of an hour is the same as 45 minutes, which is the same as the decimal 0.75. So that one we should know. 20 minutes. Well, to go from minutes to hours, we have to do the opposite. Last time we multiplied by 60, so now we would have to divide by 60 to get the fraction, which would give us 20/60, which can be simplified. The zeros cancel, and both of these are divisible by 2, so we can divide top and bottom here by 2, giving us equivalent fraction of 1/3. Well, what is 1/3 as a decimal hour? Then we have to do the division. 1/3, 1 divided by 3 goes 0 times, that 1 is left over. Decimal point in the same place. 10 divided by 3 goes 3 times, there would be 1 left over. So we start to see the pattern here that we get our recurring 3. That's equivalent to the decimal number of hours, 0.333. The dot on the top, remember here, means the recurring sign that this 3 goes on forever and ever and ever. And in maths terms, it's usual to put that recurring number over the first time it appears. So 0.3 recurring is exactly the same as 1/3 of an hour. We then have 2/3 of an hour. How would we change 2/3 of an hour into decimal hours? Well, we would divide 2 by 3. So let's do that. 2's into 3 goes 0 times, 2 left over. 3's into 20 go 6 times, 2 left over. We're going to get a repeating pattern again. It's going to be 0.6 recurring, which is approximately the same as 0.67 hours. And if we would like then to convert these hours, 2/3 of an hour, into minutes, we take the fraction, because that's the simplest way to do it, and multiply by 60. Change any hour into minutes by multiplying by 60. Well, 3's go into 60, 20 times, 2 20s are 40. So we would end up with 40 minutes. We would expect that because, of course, if 1/3 of an hour is equivalent to 20 minutes, then 2/3 of an hour must be equivalent to the double, 40 minutes. Then we have our last one, which is, what about if we have a number of hours that is bigger than 1? We have 1.25 hours. Well, as a fraction, we know that 0.25 an hour is a quarter, so 1.25 hours is equivalent to 1 1/4, which can also be written as 5/4 hours. So if we want to convert the fraction to the number of minutes, the easiest way to do it is have it as its fraction, 5/4, and multiply by 60. 4 into 60 goes 15 times. And then we just do 5 times 15. So we just need to work out 5 times 15. 5 tens are 50. 5 fives are 25, giving us 75 minutes. So 1.25 hours is the same as 75 minutes. It's an easy way to fill in the table and remind yourself of how to change from a fraction to a decimal is to just do the division. How to change from decimal hours to minutes. It's actually easier to change from fraction hours to minutes because you just multiply the fraction by 60. If you're going backwards, you need to go from minutes to hours, you divide by 60. Okay? And if you need to go from the decimal hours to the fraction hours, you look at the last number here. This was the same as 1/25/100. If you don't remember that 0.25 is exactly a quarter, you actually convert it to 25/100 and simplify it.